A good editorial calendar is going to help you feel at ease, streamlined, and organized with all of the content that you are creating for the week or for the month. And I know it's really easy to add a lot of things into the calendar and plug things in and boom, 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 before you know it, you have a whole calendar populated with content. But when you take a step back and take a look at how everything is set up, does everything flow? Is the content that you are creating providing value for your audience? And is it supporting your business, your personal brand, or growth? A thoughtfully set up content calendar helps you see which content you're creating that supports the programs, the services, or the offers that you are providing for your audience. And so today I wanted to show you how you can set up a content calendar using Airtable. If this is your first time joining me on my YouTube channel, I want to say hello. My name is Nancy Casanova and I love talking about content strategy. I love sharing tips and tutorials that help you create content with clarity and confidence. So if you're into that, make sure that you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified when the next video is up. I know that there are a lot of options out there for tools that can help you create a content calendar, but I wanted to share with you how Airtable has personally helped me streamline all of the different views and workflows that I need or that my brain needs to see as I'm creating content. So Airtable has really enabled me to better streamline my process of how I create content and moving it from ideation to completion. And if you're interested or you're curious about more of the functional aspects of how Airtable can improve your own process, you're gonna wanna keep watching. Okay, so one of the things I wanna show you that Airtable does that is really cool is it allows you to view your Airtable in different views, which I like. Here in this case, you're viewing it under sorted, like my content is sorted according to each content bucket. But another thing that it does is you can do like a post gallery view, which I love. This is where you kind of get to see how all of your designs look as you are creating them and whether they have a cohesive look and feel. And one of the things that I also like here is that I can see the channel that it's being posted on, the status of it, whether it's still in planning mode or whether I might be designing something or editing. And so I love looking at it in this view. The other thing is that you can view your posts by status, so you can group them. And so here I have everything that's like published, designing, whether I'm producing, outlining, or planning. And then the other thing I like is I like to create a calendar view of everything that's been published. I like this view because I like to see sort of like the evidence of where my content has gone from ideation to completion. And this view lets me see like evidence of my work. And I like that. It sort of lets me see like, how consistent was I? Did everything kind of flow together with a content strategy? Like, was the messaging sort of cohesive? Was it sprinkled around in the right type of mix? And I like that view. The other thing is you can also do a board view. So everybody's brain works differently. And so if you like a Kanban board, you can also do that. You can change this according to your own workflow. But in this case, I have it going from like planning to designing, editing, and then published. And so you can also view content that way. And there's just a lot of customization options. You can do like a gallery view this way where you just see the topic. I kind of like the images better. So I do it like this, but again, Airtable really allows for a lot of customization, depending on how your brain likes to be organized and how you like to visually see all of your content. So that's something that I really, really like about Airtable. Another thing I really want to point out about Airtable is that you'll see at the very top how you can see all of the different tabs that I have available. So I have like my social media content, YouTube, I have editorial, which is like for my blog post content. I have everything for my newsletter, marketing, such as opt-ins, and then relevant dates, content ideas, and things for visibility. And so all of these tabs are really cool because they all speak to one another. For example, I'm going to open up this one where it says like YouTube, a content idea on like tagging photos. So here's where I put like my video description, video notes about the music, and then the link. But another thing that is really awesome is that I have the ability to really connect all of the channels and the content that I'm repurposing within Airtable.
So in here, you'll see that there's a tab or a little section that says social media posts. And this is where I show like, okay, the video was on YouTube, but I also repurposed it to IGTV. And I also, it was like a content idea that I did on TikTok. And so you can make this as unique as you want to. Right here, I'm just gonna do it like this. This one was a TikTok, so I'm gonna change that. But it's really cool. I like the ability to see, like have a bird's eye view on everything that I'm doing and making sure that I am really maximizing and repurposing my content as often as I can. And you really want to be very intentional about this. I'm going to do this because I can do that later. But you really want to be intentional so that you're not always creating content from scratch and you're really maximizing everything. So here you'll see on this right side, it says like, that for social media posts, I did this as an IGTV and I also did it as a TikTok. So it shows like the channels that I've repurposed. And I have like the link and whether I emailed it to my newsletter subscribers. With my newsletter, I also do something similar where I'm able to show like, did I share like my YouTube video to my email newsletter? And so that pops up here. If I have social media posts that I repurposed, it shows up here under the social media tab. It says like, yeah, you did a carousel post and this one was also a carousel post. And this one was also a blog post that you repurposed under editorial. So this is sort of how I've integrated everything together. And Airtable allows you to do that through their forms. And my form, the way I have set it up is at the very bottom, you just keep adding fields, but basically, as you are customizing your field, you do add to this field, and Airtable has an option that says link to another record. And that's what I do. I choose the tab that I want it to interlink and connect with. So I could choose like, yeah, interlink, or like, I don't know if the word interlink is the proper term that Airtable would use, but that's sort of how I'm able to connect different tabs to one another. But you have like, for me, since I have a tab that says YouTube, I can connect YouTube within this form and have them speak to one another. I also have a tab for editorial, which is my blog post or content that I'm creating as a guest contributor. My newsletter, marketing, such as opt-ins or any offers that I might be working on. So let me close out of this. So right here on the far right or the top right, you'll see that I have like related dates, editorial, and YouTube. And the way that appears is, let me go to this tab for say like I'm creating, say I were to create something for like June. I'm just gonna go ahead and do that as an example. But say this is like a sample post, and then title, whatever it might be. But say this is gonna be like a TikTok video. I could leave it in planning, and if this is going to become something that I reuse from my newsletter, I scroll to the bottom and it says link to a record from newsletter. And so I click the plus button and I'm able to find like existing newsletters that could say fit in here. And if say I'm going to link from another like social media post or editorial, I could do that here. So if say I have like a YouTube video that I want to link in here, I could link that in here from a YouTube channel, or if there's another type of post that I've done, you could just kind of really interlink them. And that way you get to see like, how am I really maximizing my content? Is everything staying consistent with messaging?
By the way, if you need help with repurposing your content and maximizing your channel strategy, make sure that you download this free guide. It'll help you really streamline how you create content and help you eliminate burnout so that you're not always creating content from scratch.
So very quickly, if you were to just like get started with using Airtable, you can start here by doing like a fresh new tab. So this could be an example of like sample calendar, right? And I'll just rename that really quickly. But one of the things you can do is you can really, you know, you don't want to get too ahead of yourself and get too excited and like add too many things into this because then it could get kind of overwhelming. But you want to go down to the bottom where it says form. And I like this one where you can just do like your own content form. And it helps you really build out how you're going to build out your content calendar. And so in here, you could put like the title of your post. You can rename this to put to say title. Let me rename that here. Title. And then the status, you can really personalize this too, depending on what type of content you're creating. So a very simple one, you know, is you could do like to write. You could change this to say to edit. And then now you could say like to schedule and then complete it. And yeah, Airtable does let you change the colors, which I really like. So you could say like, you can make this one, whatever gray or whatever color you like, and you can really customize this according to what content you're creating. So if you could change this in case it might be channel driven. So if say you had a YouTube channel, you might change this to say, that you're doing keyword searches, keyword research, right? So if you are creating a podcast or YouTube, that's something that can vary. I like the ability to really customize this so that it makes sense in my brain and how I'm moving along with my workflows. And so this is one way to do that. You can really make it your own. And then that would be like an example of like, if say you're managing like a YouTube channel, and you can always change these. So I like that. That's really easy, and you can keep adding to the fields. So if say you wanted to say, you want to add a thumbnail, you can put that here for your video, and you can keep adding to that. So if you wanted to also add like, I don't know, the URL, like the final URL, you could put YouTube URL, or you could put this like blog post, right? So that's an example of how you can really build this out and make it your own. And then when you come to grid view, you can start moving these around to however you'd like.
So one of the things I wanted to also mention are the pros and cons of Airtable. And I feel like I'll start with the pros. The pros are that I love that you can set up different views, like depending on how your brain works and how your brain likes to organize things. I love the ability to have different views to sort by different dates or assets or content buckets. Like that is so great for me. I love that ability. I also love that you can really customize like your workflow, so you can change what your first step is in your status and the last step is in your process. And I love that you can make it your own. Like there's definitely a lot of customization options that really make it unique to the content that you're creating and how you like to get work done. So I love that option. That is totally like a pro on my list for Airtable. Like those are a lot, like the custom views, the sorting, the customization, and filters, all of that. So Airtable is so easy to set up that I feel like it's really easy to get excited as well. So on my cons list, I feel like it's really easy to add too many views, too many workflows, too many tabs, and like just too much that it becomes overwhelming and it could deter you from actually getting your work done. I feel like you can make an easy mistake of adding too many things to your process that you never actually end up getting it done, because you will like inadvertently hold yourself back because you're like, I have to do this and this and this and this. And you just like end up making it too long that you may not even get to completing it. So that's one of the things that I would probably note as a cons of Airtable, is that it's nice to have so much customization, but then if you like burden yourself with too many things and get too much into the weeds, it can actually get in the way of you actually getting things done. Another con is that I kind of miss checklists. I'm gonna share another video in the future about Asana, but I love the simplicity of Asana. I still use it for a project management tool, but I use all of my content, like all of my content creation happens within Airtable. But I really love checklists and sort of like the feeling that it gives me of like checking things off. And I know that there's an option to add a check mark within Airtable, but I think that this is a sort of different feeling that I like within Asana. I also kind of miss like the simplicity of the view. Like sometimes I find myself working outside of Airtable and using Google Drive because it's like distraction free and I don't feel like I have to keep adding like a form, or it's not like long form, like checklists and stuff. And it, like, I feel like Google Drive just allows me to keep it simple and just write and keep things going. But I do like that Airtable kind of lets me just map out where I want to be at the end of the month or the end of the quarter. So I think that's it. Those are my pros and cons. By the way, something I also wanted to mention is that I am using the free version of Airtable, but they keep adding new features that get me really curious about moving on to one of the paid versions of Airtable. I specifically like the ability to add in like custom colors. I think I'm big on colors. I feel like I don't want it to overwhelm me either, but that is a big draw. And I recently saw that they added the ability to add different sections. And I feel like that's something that I'm so glad that they added. I'm like, I would totally love that. So for now, I'm on the free version, but I would definitely see myself perhaps evolving into one of the paid versions of Airtable, just because I feel like it helps me so much and I use it on a daily basis. By the way, if you enjoy videos about content creation, channel strategy, content ideas, and inspiration, be sure to subscribe to my channel so you can continue to receive a weekly dose of actionable advice and tips. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe for more content inspiration tips and tutorials.